quiet. So if you have a quiet puppy, click and give a treat right now. If they are whining, barking, or crying, what you're going to do is you're just going to ignore. You're going to wait it out. All right? And once they're quiet, then you click and treat. So let's go about two more clicks for our next quiet puppy. Good thing you're nice and strong to hold people. All right, and it looks like we got our last classmate coming in. So let's go ahead and get one more click and treat for quiet. The next rule of quick to calm is if your puppy is quiet with all four paws on the floor. So if they are not jumping up, all right, or putting paws up on you, then we'll click and treat there. All right, good job. If they do jump up, what you're going to do is you're just going to wait it out. Wait until those paws hit the floor, and when they finally do, you're going to click there. Click and treat there, and then I would go A short leash shows that you are a responsible dog owner, all right? And if your dog pulls, they don't get very far. That's it with Charlie. That's perfect. So if your puppy has no tension on that leash, all right, and they are sitting down or have no tension on that leash, then you want to click and treat there. All right, if they pull, what you're going to do is you're just going to wait it out and wait some more, but just watch the stairs and make sure Maisie isn't going to think it's playtime. If you need to go drink to know if you can. So you're rewarding for your dog staying close to you, all right? That's going to help you when it comes to things like on your walks. So if they like to pull a lot on the leash, then what I would recommend is stop any motion whenever they're pulling or at the end of it. First level, just stop going after your hand.
Yep.
And if you need to, relook that leash just a little bit more so she can't wander too far from you. Come, girl. Let's get you untangled and let's bring you closer to mama. Yeah, so what will happen, guys, is that first things first, your dog may try to pester at your hand for 30 to 45 seconds until they start to figure out that, well, that's not being the other treat, so I'll do something else. So the first level is they just back away from that hand. All right, next level, or what we're ultimately looking for, is they start to offer control positions. So they offer a sit instead of going after our hand, or they offer a down instead of going after our hand. Anytime you're working or anytime you're training, your dog offers you a sit or a down, whatever they want, give it to them, because that is doggy language for asking please for something. So sit or down equals please in puppy language. All right, yeah, so keep it right at these nose levels. So you don't want to take it away to give the answer. All right, so let them figure it out on their own. Okay, so we're going to move on, guys. Also treat the hand, too. If you have a puppy who likes to be a little bit nippy or grabby whenever taking treats out of your hand and you're feeling teeth on you, you can do a treat the hand demonstration every single time. Looking at your shoe and sock. Next, once they turn that head and they're looking at you, they're not looking at that shoe or sock. They were looking to rip apart. Just a few seconds ago. So use it, as a redirect. Or if they're staring at other puppies, use it to turn that head towards you so they don't bark at their puppy friends in class. Kiki. So let's move on to some focus next. Working on some watch me's, all right? So what we want to train our puppies to do is focus up here, at our eyeballs, at our face. So let's start first by taking it 4 to 5 seconds. And then same thing, just like with the other guy, you just kind of bring those paws like putting your legs. That's okay. So then you go short on the walking record. You said watch me.
Focus.
But that treat for the sky, if you practice that one every day, you'll start to see those paws to the ground a little bit longer.
Okay.
All right. What you smell, Spirit Girl?
I don't know. I'm wondering if she has to go to the bathroom.
What you're going to do is you're going to ask your puppy to sit once. If you need to repeat anything, you can repeat the treat lure, which I'm going to show. Sit. This happens, this is what we call middle behaviors, and dogs are going to learn. They're not going to get rewarded for that. I'll just go treat back to nose and lift up until that butt goes on the ground. So let's go watch me with Charlie if she starts barking. And I'm going to reset it here. So sit. And again, all this puppy persistence.
How are you watching?
But the moment that that butt finally hits the ground is when we're going to click. So Spirit's just learning that the longer I withhold that butt on the ground, the longer it's going to be till I get my treats. So you guys go ahead, and then what you're going to do is you're going to finish with that release. So notice through this, I have not repeated once. I just repeat that treat. I'm a new exciting distraction. Click, and then treats, and then finish with the release.
Okay.
All right. And then on the second one, it's going to be less of that and more butt on the ground, all right?
So Sam starts with the command only said once, a click when the butt hits the ground, a treat, and then a release. Okay. So most common release that we use here is okay. Other ones that you hear, break, dismiss, free dog, or even release. So just decide if you do not have a release already, what you would like it to be.
It doesn't count.
Thanks, yeah. If she doesn't want to give out that position,
sure.
That's
okay.
She's not the option.
Shit. When I should have clapped. Hey, focus.
No. Hey.
Okay. I just got a little quicker. I'm learning too. Yeah, that's okay. That's why we say we train dog owners here, not the dogs. You guys are training the dogs, and I'm training you. Okay. Nice trainer.
If he misses top while he's sitting, he's very using a lot.
I wouldn't. I do only paws on the ground. So, like I said.